Let us calculate velocity at the midpoint. Imagine a body is moving with uniform acceleration on a straight line path. Let A be the starting point, B midpoint, C end point. Acceleration is constant, uniform. Let us consider velocity at A as u and velocity at C as v and midpoint velocity v dash. Since B is the midpoint, distance between A and B, if I say s, between B and C is also equal to s. Now we know that v square minus u square is 2as. Apply this equation between A and B. So v dash square minus u square is equal to 2as. In the similar way, if I apply between B and C, v square minus v dash square is equal to 2as. First and second equations, right hand side terms are equal. So automatically left hand side terms are equal. Therefore, v dash square minus u square is equal to v square minus v dash square. Bring v dash square terms to the left side and take u square to the right side. So 2v dash square is equal to u square plus v square, or simply v dash is equal to root of u square plus v square by 2. When a body moving with uniform acceleration has u and v as initial and final velocities, then the velocity at the midpoint is given by root of u square plus v square divided by 2. Now, let us consider a problem. A body moving with uniform acceleration passes three equidistant points A, B and C in its straight line path. If its velocities at A and C are 20 and 40 meter per second respectively, find the velocity at B. So data suggests at A and B, A is the initial point, B is the midpoint, C is the final point. At A it is 20, at C it is 40. Then what about the velocity at B? We know that midpoint velocity v dash is given by root of u square plus v square by 2. So from this equation it is 20 square plus 40 square divided by 2. 20 square is 400, 40 square is 1600, total is 2000. Nothing but root 1000 or 10 root 10 meter per second. This is the velocity at the midpoint when the body is moving with uniform acceleration. Now suppose if I consider B as a point which divides AC in some ratio, means B is not the midpoint, A, this is C, but B is here. U is the velocity at initial point, V final point, midpoint, V dash. But the division is, let us say, X is to Y. Means AP by BC is equal to X by Y. Again apply the same equations, V square minus V square is 2AS. First between A and B. So V dash square minus U square is 2AX. BC v square minus v dash square is equal to 2ay. Now, right hand side is not equal, so let us take the ratio between 1 and 2. First equation divided by second equation implies v dash square minus u square by v square minus v dash square is equal to x by y. Cross multiplication, y into v dash square minus y into u square is equal to x into v square minus x into v dash square. Again bring v dash square terms to one side, so it becomes v dash square times x plus y is equal to, take the u square term right side, y into u square plus x into v square. Therefore, v dash is equal to root over y into u square plus x into v square divided by x plus y. So if b is not the midpoint, then velocity at that point, if it divides the total distance in the ratio x and y, x is to y, is given by root of y into u square plus x into v square divided by x plus y. Now let us consider an example problem. A body moving with uniform acceleration passes three points A, B and C in its straight line path. If its velocities at A and C are 20 meter per second and 40 meter per second respectively, and B divides AC in the ratio 2:1, find velocity at B. So A, B, C are three points on a line. A and C extreme points, but B is not the midpoint. Velocity at A 20 meter per second and C 40 meter per second, and the ratio is 2:1. Let us apply our formula. V dash is equal to root over y into u square plus x into v square by x plus y. Here y is 1 and x is 2. So 1 into 20 square plus 2 into 40 square divided by 2 plus 1. Now simplify this equation. 20 square is 400, 40 square is 1600 times 2, 3200 divided by 3. So this is 3600 by 3, or root 1200, or 10 root 12 meter per second.